You are what you eat. Or really what you digest. So what happens to our food once we swallow? Energy that you need as you live and grow comes from your food. The chemical building blocks that become you as you grow are gained through a process called digestion. The digestive system is made up of the digestive tract, a series of hollow organs joined together in a long twisting tube. Digestion involves mixing food with digestive juices, moving it through the digestive tract, and breaking down large molecules of food into smaller pieces. Food doesn't just fall through our digestive tract. It's pushed. Our large hollow organs contain a layer of muscle that allows their walls to move and contract. This movement can propel food and liquid through the system and can also mix the contents within each organ.
This muscle action is called peristalsis. Because of peristalsis, I can just hang upside down and eat this snack.
The digestion process begins with ingestion, where we use our teeth to bite and tear and chew up our food. Then that mixture is combined with our saliva.
Holy mackerel!
Holy mackerel! We produce about a liter of saliva a day, or 4 soda cans worth. That is a lot of spit soda.
Ugh.
Then we swallow, forcing this mixture into our esophagus. Gulp, and then down into our stomach. It's kind of gross. This is called propulsion. Once the mixed up, chewed up food particles are now in our stomach, mechanical breakdown can take place. The stomach then slowly empties all of its contents into the small intestine. Digestion is now taking place here in the small intestine. Food particles break down further as the food is continually mixed and pushed along. Absorption happens as the small intestine soaks up all the nutrients from the food particles into our bloodstream. That's kind of like this towel absorbs water. So wait, this seems like a pretty quick process. So why does it take longer than like 10 minutes to digest food? Our bodies want to capitalize on all the nutrients and moisture it possibly can from the food we eat. That happens as our food travels through our small intestine, which isn't very small. It's actually over 20 feet long. That's like this long. Wait, this long. That's a lot. Now, finally, everything that is left over as waste is pushed into our colon and then is expelled from our body through a process called defecation.